terrific speed at first.
You don't really appreciate the game until afterwards.
And here comes Acacio, and Florida ties the game. Volley of view, deep to right, and gone.
I've never been in a game with so much back and forth.
Tim Walton's going to wave the time run home, the throw to the plate, and Florida has done it again.
You could feel momentum changes back and forth, and they just kept battling.
It was a grind. It's why you work out. It's why you play the sport, because moments like that.
Doesn't matter what you're feeling. Doesn't matter if you're hurting. Just clear your mind and go.
And Shay Knighton knew it was gone the second it left her bat.
Keep playing our game, all seven innings. If it's more, then it's more.
Third time, they're down to their last strike. Struck her out. Paige Lowry ends it with the K of Kvistad.
We're going to go out and fight and get everything we have because we're not going down.
Welcome to the NCAA Women's College World Series. Top-seeded Florida, they must win tonight to force Game 3, or Oklahoma takes home its third national championship in 5 years. An absolute thriller, an historic night last night for Game 1. 17 innings long, they were playing for 5.5 hours. 31 got into the game, only 5 didn't. There were nearly 500 pitches with 40 strikeouts combined between the two pitching staffs. It was Shay Knighton's prodigious blast to get the lead in the top of the 17th, and then Paige Lowry's shutdown strikeout to end it for the win for the Sooners. And we get set now for Game 2. Beth Mowens, along with Jessica Mendoza, Michelle Smith, Holly Rowe is with us tonight as well. Your takeaway, ladies, from how that 17-inning game last night is still going to be felt here tonight.
It's how we predicted it, in the sense this is the number one seed against the defending national champions. And when you think about it, the last 10 years, you could argue these are the two best programs in softball. And it was the first time they ever matched up, and that's why it did not disappoint.
Epic, masterful. There's a million words you could describe last night's game. But to the pitching staffs, I think what was amazing is that both clubs had to use their day two starter. So as hard as that was on both staffs, I think it was far worse on Florida because they took the loss.
Now, Oklahoma had the surprise starter yesterday. Tonight, the surprise starter for Florida.
And Acacio has thrown just 2 innings in this postseason. Look at Parker, almost 50. So 2 different tails, absolutely. Acacio, though, the one thing about her is she's extremely consistent. We have seen her all over the field at third base hitting the ball. Her team is going to be working very hard behind her to try to help her out.
And it was a Florida team that kept coming back. Even though they didn't get the win, they were fighting, Jess, to the point where they had the game-winning run at the plate in the 17th.
I don't know if it was the 9th inning or the 10th inning. All of a sudden, the game got the feel that this was the championship. This was Game 3 because everyone knew how important this was. But Florida, bottom of the 7th, they did not give up. Tie game down by 1, 2 outs, 2 strikes, they tie it. And then the bottom of the 12th, they do it again. Now down by 2, 2 outs, 2 strikes. They tied it. They would threaten again in the bottom of the 17th after that Shay Knighton home run. They scored a run. This is a team that fights, and I think this is a team that will get us to a Game 3.
Game 2 coming up. Both sides know that last night was a classic, and they are hoping for another one tonight.
It was like 2 heavyweight fighters throwing punch after punch.
It was up to us to kind of punch back and want to fight back and not want to back down.
I don't know if it was the 8th or the 21st, whatever inning it was.
Excited to go to sleep and wake up. Tomorrow's a new day, and we're still in the national championship. We have 2 more games left.
Oklahoma City as we get set for Game 2 of the championship series.
Well, now let's take a look at our Capital One starting lineups for the Florida Gators. Starts at the very top of the lineup with the best hitter in this lineup, Amanda Lorenz. 4-12 this tournament and 5 RBIs.
They've changed their lineup a bit today, moving around Nicole DeWitt. She's come up in the order. Alicia Acacio has as well. She'll bat third as Kvistad drops from second down to fourth. 5, 6, and 7 go Wheaton, Sophia Reynoso, and a new DP today in Brooke Clemens. And the bottom two will stay the same, Chelsea Herndon and Justine McLean. You've got six lefties in a row and then three righties all packed in together against the lefty ace for the Sooners, Paige Parker, who has never lost in her 2 years here at the Women's College World Series. Eight straight wins also ties a record for most in a row in series history in this, our 36th tournament. If Oklahoma wins, they are the champs. If Florida wins, we come back again tomorrow. Amanda Lorenz, the sophomore from Moore Park, California, an All-American, riding a nine-game hit streak. Drove in three runs last night, including a big two-run double in the bottom of the 12th. Paige Parker did not have a hand in the decision last night, came on in relief. She has won 18 straight decisions. Split time in the circle with Paige Lowry last night. Junior out of Independence, Missouri. Started out the season 3-3, has gone 23-2 since then. And walks Lorenz on four pitches.
Paige Parker, the lefty, extremely successful in the circle and in Oklahoma City. Why? Because she's got a hoppy rise at the top of the zone, but she'll also work a curveball away from lefties as well as backdoor. Backdoor to righties, inside to lefties, but it's that changeup that is just so devastating. She mixes speeds to all parts of the zone, but she's going to have to work from ahead. In last night's game, she hurt herself walking leadoff batters. In fact, three walks in the game in her relief appearance.
This is Nicole DeWitt out of Garden Grove, California, dropping down the sacrifice. Romero over to first. Lorenz down to second, one away. Florida three straight SEC regular season championships. OU six in a row out of the Big 12. Each of these programs has two national championships in the last 4 years, so we're deciding who gets ownership of the dynasty here in the last decade. Along with Alabama, these are two of the top three winningest programs over the course of the last 10 years. With the rise of the SEC and the counterpunch of Oklahoma. Ocasio pops it up. Knighton fighting the sun. Shea's got it, two down. Tim Walton in his 12th season won national championships in 2014 and 15. Denied the three-peat as the one seed last year and returning as the one seed this year, trying to become the sixth top-seeded team to win it all in the last 13 years. Kavista, the junior from Lake City, Florida. Struggled last night. That's why she dropped a couple spots, 0 for 7. She's got home run power, though. Had a chance to win it in the bottom of the 17th, and Lowry struck her out. So many intriguing side stories, side statistics last night. They had seven chances to walk off with runners on base in extra innings last night. Could not get that timely hit.
And that's what makes it tough to go to bed at night. And you get after that game and you're, first of all, you're amped, all the emotions. But when you lose a game, you go through all the what-ifs. And for Florida, there were many.
You usually go through every at-bat. It takes a long time to go through seven at-bats, though.
Two walks to the first four she has faced.
And I felt like we saw it last night, a little bit of timidness from Paige Parker. Normally she spins the ball and lets the ball do the work, but you can see tonight, a little bit last night, she looks like she's steering it. It's probably the worst thing you can do as a pitcher. You got to throw it, spin it, trust it.
It's such a strategic game going on between these two coaching staffs. We saw Tim Walton, who is an Oklahoma grad, played baseball, won a championship with the Sooners, former Patty Gasso assistant. You see Missy Lombardi, who's walking back towards the dugout, the Oklahoma assistant coach, who played at OU, and one of her teammates was Tim Walton's assistant, Jen Rocha, who is calling the pitches and played for Patty Gasso at Oklahoma.
These programs so connected, yet they had not faced each other until last night with those two head coaches.
Both playing in the finals for the fifth time. Janelle Wheaton with two on, a chance for Florida to strike quickly. That's inside the bag, fair ball, and Knighton will step on first. A couple of walks, a couple left on. Oklahoma picking up the bats when we come back.
Home Series is presented by the Quicksilver Card from Capital One. Earn unlimited 1.5% cash back every purchase everywhere. And in part by Northwestern Mutual. Northwestern Mutual, we help you live life differently. And Lowe's.
Now the scenes from last night's classic 17-inning game one. And the Sooners got the win. Shea Knighton, the three-run home run in the 17th. To the bottom of the first, Sooners will be stepping into that batter's box. Our starting lineups brought to you by Capital One. Nicole Mendez in the leadoff spot, followed by Kaylee Clifton. And then last night's hero, Shea Knighton. And right behind her, Fale of You.
Fale of You, five RBIs here in Oklahoma City, but none bigger than the two-run shot she hit in the 12th last night against Florida.
Nicole Penley right behind her. And then it's Sydney Romero, had an RBI single last night. Bottom three struggled. Macy Hatfield, Leah Wodak, and then Kelsey Arnold. The bottom three spots in the order were 0-for-19. They're looking to get the job done here tonight against Alicia Ocasio, the surprise starter. Her first start, in fact, since April 30th at Tennessee, and her only loss of the season. She's 8-1.
Yeah, and don't let that fool you. She has pitched here in Oklahoma City. She's a lot of down in the zone with a drop in the curve. She's very consistent, typically works ahead, and she will waste a rise ball. She'll also mix speeds. She threw here in Oklahoma City her freshman year, but has not thrown a lot lately with the emergence of Barnhill and Gourley as the aces for the Gators.
She picked up a win in that game, as a matter of fact. Was not going to get as much time in the circle this year, so she made a deal with Tim Walton. Hey, I want to hit some more, find a spot for me in the field. So she's been playing right field and third base and hitting well and pitching much less. Big opportunity for her here tonight, and it will start with Nicole Mendez, the freshman of the year in the Big 12. Nicole was terrific during the regular season. Just three hits here at the World Series, but one of those was a solo home run last night. So last night, Oklahoma has the surprise starter in Paige Lowry. Tonight, it's Florida. Mendez looking to go opposite field, and Nicole Mendez with the leadoff home run. Sending an early message for the Sooners.
And Ocasio on a 2-1 count leaves a pitch a little bit sweet. And this is the problem with not having pitched in a while. is you can leave the ball a little bit too much over the white part of the plate, and Mendez outer half just drives it the opposite way. Huge leadoff home run for the freshman.
What a start for OU. And the early lead in a game, if they win, they repeat as national champions. Kaylee Clifton, second team All-American, who was 1-for-7, scored a run last night. .349 on the season for Kaylee with 8 home runs. Local product from Wayne, Oklahoma. Back-to-back hits off of Ocasio to start the game. Sometimes you got to adjust on the fly. And JT Gasso, the assistant, their hitting coach, this was pregame in the dugout showing the players video of Ocasio on his phone.
You got to love the technology. That's 20 minutes prior, and sometimes that's the best time. It's fresh in your mind. You get a visual. And even that last hit was a good pitch, but these Sooners are ready.
Patty Sun, who works with the hitters, and all of these Oklahoma Sooners take ownership in the game plan and how they prep. This is Shea Knighton. A couple hops, Ocasio will let it dribble foul.
And we scout pitchers. What do they throw? Are they up in the zone, down in the zone? But the most important element besides what they throw is where they locate pitches. And when you're not sharp, when you're not throwing on a daily basis, it's hard to keep a ball at the kneecap or up at the letters without it leaking or bleeding back into the zone. And I think that's what we're seeing from Ocasio right now. She's just not game sharp.
0-2 to Knighton, misses away.
Well, and to be honest, when you faced Kelly Barnhill, and yes, Delaney Garley as well, but Barnhill throwing up to 70 miles an hour, it helps to come in. And Ocasio, what she's used to is getting a start in a game where 64-66 looks fast.
Knighton deep in the hole. They'll get the lead runner at second. Reynoso over to DeWitt. Let's check in with Holly Rowe.
And the one thing you can't see on video scouting, though, is the actual speed and velocity. So when Ocasio was throwing her 5 warm-up pitches, JT Gasso had the entire team standing at the top of the dugout looking at that so they could be on time, making sure they understand her speed and how she's going to change it.
They have adjusted quickly, Holly.
And I feel like Ocasio, what she does very well when she throws is she usually gets hitters in the first inning because she will quick pitch. She gets on that rubber and she attacks hitters very quickly, and that usually takes time, and that's where the video helps you adjust.
And she doesn't have enough disparity between her off-speed drop. She throws a drop and an off-speed drop. That off-speed drop right now is about 60 miles an hour. She needs to slow that down to 58, 56 miles an hour. So there's differential between her hard drop at 66, 67.
There's Jen Rocha, and that's Delaney Gorley over her shoulder. Nobody in the bullpen. Assistant Coach of the Year a couple years ago when the Gators won their second national championship. They've come here with some awfully good pitchers over the years, including Stacy Nelson, and then their championship winners, their aces Hannah Rogers and Lauren Hager, and Delaney Gorley and Ocasio all a part of that. DeWitt over to first, 2 down, had the hit and run on. That'll bring up Nicole Penley. Junior from New Mexico, batting 286 in this World Series. 4 home runs so far in the NCAA tournament. She's happy to see neither Barnhill nor Gurley. She struck out 5 times in game one.
The changeup was a pitch that really got her. She was not seeing the ball well yesterday against that pitch.
Yeah, she struggled more against Gurley than she did Barnhill. Barnhill, she hit a double, roped the ball to the wall, was up in the box. But that change of speed can just be nasty at times.
Another crazy stat from game one. The Gators with 26 strikeouts, and they lost.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be surprised if they go with something off speed here. They're just coming on the hands of Penley. That's what she threw. And I really enjoyed the sequence of pitches that both these teams, Jen Rocha for Florida, and Missy Lombardi for Oklahoma. It's not always the strikeout pitch. It's the pitch that sets it up before it.
Grounded to short and a collision, and Knighton will be called for interfering with the defender. Side retired, but the Sooners strike first.
Nicole Mendez with her second home run in this champ series. Look at the launch angle on this from above to get the Sooners on the board. She leads off with a big one to homer.
Well, game one of the World Series last night was one of the most epic we have ever seen. It went well into the night. The game time was over 5 hours. We didn't get out of here until about 12:38 last night was the final pitch. So both teams had some extensive recovery work to do. Today, Oklahoma went to the Dodgers AAA facility at the ballpark here in Brickyard and took ice baths. Paige Lowry said, actually, I'm shocked. I'm not sore at all. They used the Normatec recovery flush system on the pitcher's arms, and they said they're feeling pretty well. For Florida, they got up early and did some nutritional recovery foods, blueberries and cherry juice that are known to reduce inflammation. They did a nice pool workout at their hotel, and then they've got a traveling masseuse. Kelly Barnhill said, I just told her, hey, work on this whole side of my body from the shoulder on down. Delaney Gorley said her only soreness is in her feet, but they are all feeling pretty good. The one thing, though, that Tim Walton did that I think is brilliant, he took their phones last night. He said, I didn't want them laying in bed, scrolling through social media, reliving that game again. No phones, focused sleep, Florida. Pretty brilliant move.
No phones for a college athlete? That's a big move. Well done.
17 innings, 5.5 hours last night, 496 pitches. And that also means, by the way, 496 pitches caught, those two catchers squatting, and the umpires as well. Hats off to all of them last night. One nothing lead for the Sooners on the Nicole Mendez home run. If they win, they're the champs. Six, seven, eight here for the Gators. We'll get on a play.
Pulled a hammy.
Gator pulled a hammy.
Trying to dive for that foul ball.
His arms aren't long enough to catch.
Holly, I think he needs the nutritional rehab. Can we set that up for him, please?
Maybe a little massage.
Here's the 1-2 to Reynosa.
Oh, wow. That's a big miss.
That is.
Albert probably can't see real well.
Mm-mm. That's a good point. It's hard to see through your teeth.
We also the freshman from Palmdale, California. She showed some real heart last night. A couple of big hits. She gets into one. That is deep. And she sends it out. Reynoso ties it for Florida. Just her third of the season, and it's one apiece.
And the count, guys, one ball, two strikes. This is a pitch that I think Parker wants a lot higher than it is, but watch where Reynoso is able to get to. She does something where she shows bunt, comes back so that she's able to help her track and get a ball that's right in the strike zone at the letters that she can drive, and boy, does she, out to left field. You're seeing a lot of these Florida Gator hitters with Parker. A lot of strikeouts, a lot of outs, fly balls up in the zone. And so you'll see these Gator hitters square around like they're doing right now. Brooke Clemens. And then pull the back back.
And I can tell you by Parker's body language already, the home plate umpire, Terry Holt, is a little bit tight for what Parker, the zone she likes to throw through. And I can just tell the way she is reacting that she's struggling, figuring out where she wants to throw pitches and how she wants to throw them through the zone.
This is Brooke Clemens, who gets the start as a designated player. And this was an interesting move for Tim Walton. Her last hit is April 2nd. She got a couple of at-bats last night. She only has three hits on the season, but their DP role struggled last night, and they decided not to go with Hoover, the starting third baseman.
When I saw her come off the bench to pinch hit, Tim Walton, after one swing, ran into the dugout and said something. And I really believe he saw something in her swing against Parker that he wanted noted, that obviously he's bringing her back again for today. And she didn't get on base, so it must have been something with her being able to lay off a pitch, get on time, but he liked it against Parker.
Full count. Out to center, Penley coming on. One away. Let's go back to look at Sophia Reynoso. Two big hits in the first two games of this champ series.
I think the biggest part of it is her selection and being able to get a pitch that she can drive, and that's the difference of a pitch that doesn't continue to elevate, that you can get up in the zone as a hitter.
And one and two, that pitch should be at least 6 inches higher if you're coming inside.
Slap to short, takes a nice hop up into the glove for Arnold, two down. Lingering effects from the 5.5 hour game last night. Couple of early home runs already off the two starting pitchers tonight. Number nine hitter, Justine McLean. Had three hits in game one. And her batting average right now here at the World Series is the best on the team.
I think we're going to see a lot less strikeouts. We're going to see more balls put in play, and we're going to see more runs. This is going to be the kind of game I think you want in a championship, not the pitcher's duel, but a lot of offense.
Yeah. Well, and the ball flies differently here in Oklahoma City than it does, obviously, in Gainesville. The dew point a lot higher in Gainesville, so there's the air is heavier. It doesn't fly out of the yard. In fact, when we talked to the Gator players earlier, they were like, wow, this
fun
is great. The ball is just flying out of the yard.
A lot of humidity as well in Gainesville. Thanks to our staff meteorologist, Anthony DeMarco, for that information. One, two to McLean. That'll fall fair from McLean. Thought about second, and now we'll go. Hatfield misplayed it out and left. And a runner in scoring position with the top of the order, and Lorenz coming up.
Just a good job of placement. You see McLean finds that one spot in the field, just a half slap to be able to poke it in there, and the spin. Hatfield needed to break down. And especially once she saw that McLean wasn't going to second, take your time, field it, especially if it's spinning like that.
Yeah, there's no reason to bare hand that ball.
A single and an E7 in your scorebook. Amanda Lorenz in her first at-bat walked on four pitches. This is the 131st game of her career. She has reached base on all but four of them.
And I think this is where you stay. If you're Paige Parker, that last strike, up and away, I mean, it's a borderline call. Stay there. Don't come over the plate with Amanda Lorenz. Up and away again, and I like that. Nicole DeWitt, yes, she's a great hitter on deck. I mean, you got the heart of the order, but this is the one right now that you circle, and Amanda Lorenz, she can't beat you. She almost did last night.
Low and away.
Yeah, she did in the 12th tournament last night.
Yeah.
Four of their five runs in game one scored with two outs.
Yep, I think this is a smart move.
She walks for the second time. And Patty Gasso wants to see if Nicole DeWitt can beat him here. Laid down a sacrifice back in the first inning. Batting 308 so far in the World Series. Parker's change at 52 miles an hour. A lot of three ball counts, already three walks. Her pitch count is rising rapidly. After throwing 108 in relief yesterday. There's the starter from game one, as well as the closer from game one, Paige Lowry.
Now again, one ball, two strikes, the same count that she gave up the home run. Make her chase. Whether you go upstairs, then go upstairs. Go head or above. If you go away, go off the plate away.
DeWitt, base hit to left. The runners will move up 60 feet. And they are loaded for Alicia Ocasio.
And this is a credit to Nicole DeWitt. The range that she has on this swing, she just completely sells out. Watch her just say, okay, I know this is a way. She doesn't even use her lower half. She just throws her hands and barrel at this ball. She barely even swings through all the way and just pokes it. That's her being a short gamer and understanding what to do with that pitch.
Stays outside to Ocasio.
Parker's pitch is just not sharp. Her misses are too big. She doesn't have that late sharp break that induces the swings. Florida's seeing her very well, and obviously a lot of that could be the 108 pitches they saw from her last night.
Two and oh.
You know, they haven't challenged these lefties in a lot either. Both those pitches away. I wonder if she tries to come in here.
She normally works that inside curveball.
There she comes.
And that's the pitch that sets you off a little bit to make the outside look even further off the plate.
Foul. Paige Parker has literally grown up in this setting. Last year as a sophomore, 5-0. Most outstanding player of the World Series.
And
this year, 3-0. Patty Gasso telling us how much she loves this setting. Does not look comfortable in it right now. Trying to fight through it.
And that's the pitch. I was just going to say, come back with the changeup.
And she's not locating that pitch at all. She struggled with it last night. She's really trying to hide it off to the left side of her body. Almost wonder if Florida has picked it a little bit, and she's adjusting her motion to try to hide that pitch.
Base hit through the right side. McLean will score. Florida puts the brakes on Lorenz, and they are still loaded. Ocasio drives in the go-ahead.
Another two-strike, two-out RBI hit for the Gators. This has been their strength. They know how to get a pitch that they can find, battle off the ones that they can't. So much credit to this Gators team because they continue to do it, and that is so tough, especially on this stage. Two strikes, two outs. Alicia Casio gets a big RBI.
Over 30 pitches this inning. Four hits and a walk, including the home run, the leadoff by Sofia Reynoso. Mariah Lopez was out in the Oklahoma bullpen. And are the Sooners taking Parker out and going to the freshman? It appears so. Pitching change for OU, the Gators on top.
Philadelphia Zoo. The zoo changes you.
It matches the shortest start of the season for Paige Parker. Just 1 2/3 innings, 44 pitches, 3 walks, and a couple of earned runs. And Mariah Lopez, the freshman from Saugus, California, will make her second appearance in the NCAA tournament and her World Series debut with the bases full of Gators. Just over 7 innings in the regionals and supers, and a high ERA. Facing Kvistad, she's the 8th Gator to come to the plate. A home run for Reynoso, the RBI single for Alicia Ocasio. After Florida had fallen behind 1-0. And it hit her, and that will force in a run. Patty Gasso's out there talking with the home plate umpire, Terry Hole, probably wondering if she was still in the batter's box when it hit her, if she leaned over the plate. That appeared to be over the plate.
And because the ruling says that as long as you're in the batter's box, you don't see hitters try to get out of the way, if anything, even lean in. I think the rule needs to change to where batters need to at least make an attempt.
Totally agree.
So you're not seeing the, especially because they're so protected. So it's easy now to just to throw out an elbow and say, all right, RBI.
Janelle Wheaton into foul territory, and over to make the catch is Hatfield. Side retired. 3 runs across, forcing Parker to the side.
Sofia Reynoso sets the tone early for the Gators, responds to OU going up 1. She fires back with this home run. The Gators get 2 more.
Your local Cadillac dealer today.
Florida, the number 1 seed, that's huge in itself.
It's going to be a dogfight once again. I mean, they're not going to give it to us easy.
Stress, adrenaline, you're tired and you're not tired.
Everything we got. We'll give everything we have, and we're going to leave it all on the field.
Sofia Reynoso with the leadoff home run in the top of the second, and that got the Gators going. They have the 3-1 lead. The Sooners have won 4 games after trailing this postseason, including the semifinals here at the World Series and Game 1 last night.
Leadoff for Oklahoma, third baseman. To
Sydney Romero, 6-7-8 coming up. Sophomore from San Diego. 267 here at the World Series. She was 2-for-7 with an RBI last night. She was the only Sooner not to strike out against Barnhill and Gourley. has not struck out in 80 plate appearances in her two seasons in the NCAA tournament. Has an incredible eye and bat control.
Yeah.
Really remarkable. And was the only one to survive the K carnage last night at the plate.
It can be a good and bad thing. I mean, overall, definitely so positive, but sometimes you'll see her with less than two strikes put balls in play because she can. So she'll ground out check swing because she can reach stuff when sometimes it's almost better to just swing and miss or take the strike.
Yeah. Is it better to barrel up a ball or to foul off balls than potentially be retired on a pop-up, a weak pop-up somewhere? But it's pretty incredible to not strike. I mean, it shows her approach.
And her eye. I mean, right now, yes. To be able to decipher the swings, the pitches she needs to swing at, those not.
Grounded to Reynoso. It's short. One down. Well, Thursday Night Baseball features one of the great rivalries in all of sports. It's the Yankees and the Red Sox. They will play their final game of the AL East Series. The second-place Sox trying to draw even closer to the Yanks atop the East. Yankees-Red Sox on Thursday Night Baseball at 7 Eastern on ESPN.
And the Red Sox will host the Tigers for Sunday Night Baseball this weekend.
Oh. Always makes the AL East interesting when the Yanks and Sox are battling back and forth. Says Macy Hatfield. So here come the bottom three in the order, who could not make any noise in game one. They've been good prior to that. Look at that, 0 for 19 with 12 strikeouts. They only got on base twice.
Well, and they know it, and you'll see this bottom of the order. Now, Kelsey Arnold is someone that can get hot and really do a good job, but both Hatfield and Wodak, who's on deck, you'll see them try to lay down a bunt, try to do all kinds of stuff because they're around 200 hitters. They know that they're there for their defense.
And even if you don't have the highest batting average, I think the most important aspect to work on in your game is your on-base percentage.
Just be a base runner.
Exactly. Yep. Do something. Work pitchers deep into counts, foul off pitches, but just find a way to continue to help your team, even if the batting average isn't where you want it to be.
And there's the base hit for Macy Hatfield. Senior out of Maysville, Oklahoma, gets on base.
Expect the bunt to be on for Patty Gasso. She is someone that could be very traditional, but also do new stuff to try to move runners. But a lot of times, she gets that leadoff runner on, even with one out, she'll bunt him over.
Wodak does not square.
And Hatfield does run fairly well. 10 steal attempts on the season. 8 of those successful, but Janelle Wheaton, a left-handed catcher behind the plate. So a little bit more difficult for Wheaton now that there's a right-handed batter up. Typically that's on the left side. You're worried about that with the left-handed hitters.
Wodak is just 1 for 12 so far in the World Series. Takes a strike. You surprised there's no sacrifice here?
In a leverage count at 2-0, button run, hit and run, just something to put the defense in motion.
Yep. There is one out. You've got your 9 hitter on deck, but Arnold has shown some pop. In fact, Kelsey was their best hitter at the World Series prior to game one. And it works out all right. She draws the walk. 2 on for Arnold. Kelsey 0-6 in game one. She's the senior from Tulsa, Oklahoma, who had a big hand in their turnaround when they were struggling in the non-conference part of the season. Patty Gasso told us she basically understood she had to change her personality. She had to become a lot more outgoing and build relationships and build team chemistry and get everybody on the same page. And was able to do that and help the Sooners win 37 of their last 39 games. After losing their first game of the NCAA tournament, they have won 10 in a row. 2-1 to Arnold. Very similar story to how they won the national championship last year. Popped up the bunt attempt. The one difference right now, however, is Parker was spectacular in the circle. And from what we saw last night and today, Paige might have some things to work out. Alongside Paige Lowry, yesterday's game winner. Two from Ocasio. Right out in front, nowhere to go with it. And the bottom of the order has loaded the bases.
For the home run hitter, Nicole Mendez. Her last at bat, she sent it deep. She's back in the first inning. She took a pitch opposite field, drove it out. Launch angle, getting underneath it. And her home run last night, she pulled out to right field on a rise ball. So Nicole Mendez showing a variety of pitches, which will make it very difficult. And that's why you see the pitching coach coming out right now to talk to Ocasio to figure out how you game plan. We got nowhere to put her. But where do you throw her?
And how about 7, 8, and 9 for Oklahoma after struggling last night, loading up the bases in the bottom of the second. And both these clubs, you can tell, watched a lot of video today, made some adjustments. And it's not just video about opposing pitchers. It's about your own swing as well, your game plan. What do you want to hit?
And a pitching change coming now for Florida as well. So both sides have to go to their pens early. And just like for Oklahoma, Florida will make a switch with the bases loaded. Now Delaney Gourley comes on. She threw 8 innings last night, 123 pitches on in relief.
Well, and part of the reason she's coming on is because of her ability to mix speeds. The Sooners could not pick up the changeup last night. Look at the way she flips this ball out. It spins in the opposite direction. Look at where contact should be at the front foot. The ball still 3 feet in front of home plate. Again, at contact, 3 feet out in front of home plate, which means that the Sooners simply are not identifying that pitch, seeing that pitch, not even able to make a mid-swing adjustment.
13 strikeouts for Gourley as Ocasio will stay in the game and play third base. And Mendez yanks one foul down the first baseline.
How comfortable are both these teams with the pitchers? And then we saw that with Paige Parker, now with Gourley. Doesn't mean that they can't get out, but such a comfort level after seeing so much of them last night.
Gave up the 2 earned runs last night, her first in 65 innings. But also stymied the Sooners to the tune of 4 consecutive innings of no-hit pitching. Ahead of Mendez, 0-2.
Back to back on the changeup, and she's elevating a little bit And I wonder now, 0-2, she either throws it again in the dirt, makes her chase, or she comes back in on the hands that she had done on the first pitch.
And remember, Mendez hit that rise ball that was up at her head earlier. So waste a pitch, but get it out of the zone.
Oh, whiffs at that one away. Got her with the change. Two down.
Well, this is how they pitch Nicole Mendez. They come inside for the foul ball to set up the changeup. A good call that they get up in the zone. Go back to back with it. Mendez fouls it off. Now she's got to protect. This is a ball, but she sees it almost in the same location. Has to swing. So even though this is a ball, you watch it out of her hand, and she sees it as the same location away. Just keeps on tailing off the plate. Great pitch by Delaney Gourley.
That'll bring up Kaylee Clifton, singled in the first. Hit the knees, 1-1. Early lead for OU erased. Florida puts a three spot on the board in the top half of the second. The Sooners trying to counter. 1-2.
As a hitter, you know that the changeup is always an option. And with two strikes, you have to protect that, but then also keep up with the velocity of what she could throw.
Outside with the off-speed. Same pitch, same spot. Full count. Hatfield, Wodak, and Arnold. The bottom three in the order. Loaded them up for the top. And Gourley walks in a run.
Gourley's last couple changeups out of the strike zone. She looked careful on them. I think both these clubs are picking each other's pitches and the pitcher's being a little bit careful. So Gourley's going to come back with a rise ball knowing that potentially her changeup is picked. That pitch well out of the zone. Sooners cut the lead in half.
And now it's Shea Knighton with the bases loaded. A three-run home run last night. Knighton sends that one towards the gap. Extra bases for Shea, and she will clear the bags. A three-run double puts the Sooners back in front.
If you want a star in Oklahoma City, I'll give you one. Shea Knighton, she does it for her team last night. She gets a big one here. First pitch, she's sitting away. She drives this to the wall to clear the bases to get her team back on top. It's what she did last night. She does it again, continuing to elevate this offense.
And that's a backdoor curveball that just leaked back into the zone. And Knighton just fries it the opposite way.
Both are big hits with two outs. The home run last night, the three-run double tonight. In her NCAA career, she is averaging over an RBI per game, is Shea Knighton. Hitting .416. In her two trips to the Women's College World Series, has put together quite a resume.
To me, that's the result of picking pitches, knowing what's coming, pitchers changing their game plan a little bit, not going back to that pitch that's been so successful.
Fale with five runs batted in here in the series, including a two-run home run off the glove of Ocasio. Knighton will hold at third. Infield hit for review.
Just off of Ocasio's glove, and because of that change of direction going off of the glove, Reynoso, no opportunity. She does a good job, Reynoso, diving for that, making sure that Knighton cannot score. If that ball trickles out onto the green, there's a good chance Knighton comes around to score as well.
The bottom three in the order railroaded last night. 0 for 19 with 12 strikeouts. And they come back to stay today and start the rally here in the bottom of the second.
And I don't think the offense is done for either team. This was a game that was predicted to have a lot of it because of how many pitches were thrown by these pitchers last night. As you see Fale of you take second base after the catcher throws the back. This is a delayed steal, so she had gotten the lead. Waits until the catcher to almost not pay attention to her. So she takes the lead. You see her off on the right, then goes after the throw is back to the pitcher, and Gourley doesn't see it. Neither does Wheaton. Heads up base running by the Sooners.
Henley lifts one out to right. Chelsea Herndon's got it. Nine to the plate. Four of them make it home.
Shay Knighton, folks, drives one out to left field last night. She drives one to right for the double, clears them all. Sooners are up.
Don't just bank, bank human.
Game three in 2016, last year at the World Series. A home run for Shay Knighton, a walk-off to beat Alabama. A big home run against LSU last year in the World Series. Last night, the game winner in the top of the 17th off a National Player of the Year, Kelly Barnhill. Add three more RBIs to that number, folks, because she's added a three-run double to get Oklahoma back on top, 5-3.
Just look at those numbers. You see hitters come here and they get destroyed numbers-wise because the pitching is so good. And Shay Knighton has said it. She's told Holly Rowe, she's told all of us, I love the big stage. You can say it. She proved it, and she continues to do so with the bat.
That was the response for the Sooners after the Gators scored three in the top of the second, and it was Reynoso that started it with a solo home run. Swats that out to left. Hatfield's got it, one down. We had four pitchers last night that threw over 100 pitches. We figured that the hitters, after seeing so much of them, might have the advantage today. They showed that in the second inning. And that is Kelly Barnhill, who was just out in the bullpen, now coming back in to the dugout for Florida. It's going to be all hands on deck tonight. We've already seen four pitchers in the first couple of innings.
And this is where the Gators, they're going to, as you mentioned, have to use everybody. They've got to be able to get to a game three. So even though you may have the deficit, there's a good chance you still see Barnhill come in the game to try to keep it close so their offense can try to put some numbers back on the board and get back in this.
Coming up in on the hands of Brooke Clemens. Mariah Lopez throwing the biggest pitches of her life now tonight. One of the reasons Patty Gasso recruited her, she's a winner. Played in a lot of big games in travel ball.
And as a freshman, has a lot of different mixes. She makes you look all over the zone. She'll work a curve away from you. She'll work back under your hands, up and down in the zone. She mixes speeds, and you don't always see that from a freshman pitcher.
Yeah, usually they think they have all those pitches,
yeah.
But they only have one or two.
Well, and she's a great complement to the two left-handed Pages.
That's Clemens. to chase the rise. Two down. Let's check in with Holly.
Well, speaking of all hands on deck, Beth, even Oklahoma has started warming up an additional pitcher. That's their right fielder, Nicole Mendez, who only has started two games this year, hasn't pitched since the first week in May. But when we asked her if she wants to get in the circle more.
Herndon gets a hold of one. And that's gone. Solo home run, Chelsea Herndon. They pull back within one. She celebrates her birthday by going deep.
Well, it's a pitch right over the middle of the plate. We're seeing a lot more of this today, and the hitters are capitalizing. She crushes it right off the bat. Does a nice job of staying through it. She's celebrating the moment she gets to first base, jumping around the bases.
Second home run for the Gators. Oklahoma has hit four through the first game and a half. Also noteworthy, it's not the home run hitters you would suspect. Reynoso hit a home run earlier, just her third of the season. That's only the fifth of the year for Herndon. So seeing it well and muscling it out. Lopez gets the signal from Lombardi, checks that wristband. McLean fouls it off. Florida, based on what we saw last night, probably not done yet. They were down to their final strike in the bottom of the seventh, scored a run to tie it. They were down two in the bottom of the 12th, scored a couple of runs to tie it. Ground out to short, side retired, but a run back for the Gators.
If you like offense, buckle up, folks. Not only is Florida not done, OU and both these teams showing off the bats from 1 through 9.
Women's College World Series Finals. If Florida wins tonight, we will be back tomorrow. But right now, the Sooners up a run. The Florida pitching spotless, literally, through the first 18 innings of this World Series, did not give up a run, but the last 20 innings have been a different story in the circle. In particular, the five home runs, three of them yesterday in game one. Fly ball out to right. One down as Romero is retired. How about the difference 24 hours makes? We've got 11 hits through the first three innings tonight. We did not get to 11 combined hits until guess which inning last night? 11
seven,
combined hits.
12.
12 is correct.
Wow.
Cheater.
The 12th, no, I was, I
12th inning. We didn't have 11 hits until the 12th inning.
Wasn't cheating.
Pitcher, typical pitcher, two down on the ground now to Reynoso.
I count those hits.
Well, tonight after the Women's College World Series, catch SportsCenter at night with Kenny and John Anderson. They'll have all the breakdown from our game, plus the latest from the NBA, the French Open, MLB, and much, much more at SportsCenter at night, coming up after our softball game on ESPN.
Which home run package are they going to choose for SportsCenter tonight? Because they're definitely showing some offensive highlights, that's for sure.
And as hard as it was to be in the batter's box last night, it's equally as hard to be in the circle tonight.
Holly Rowe reported that between innings, the last inning, Nicole Mendez was in the bullpen for Oklahoma. Rarely used in the second half of the season. And their starting right fielder has gone back out there again between innings to throw a little bit.
Wow.
You wonder if they can go to Lowry if need be late in this game to try and preserve a lead if they have it.
Well, I think they do, but they also have to make sure that they have options in case things do fall apart in the game. If there is a game three, they want to make sure they at least have one tank full.
I think they approach Lowry as a closer. Like, she's
absolutely
your seventh inning pitcher, but right now they're looking at long relief. Who's going to be our long relief if needed? And that would be Mendez.
Yeah, they have to get to the fifth inning. I think if they get to the fifth with a lead, we see Parker in for the sixth and seventh.
Holly Rowe said she talked to Paige pregame. Lowry said she was good to go. She threw 10 innings, 8 hits, 7 strikeouts, including the strikeout of Kaylee Kvistad to end the game in the 17th with the game-winning run at the plate. Leah Wodak out to left. 3 up and 3 down. A good inning for Gourley and the Gators. Through 3, a one-run lead for the Sooners. And their boss, Patty Gasso, talking with Holly on the other side.
1, Oklahoma with a 5-4 lead. Here with Oklahoma coach Patty Gasso. And coach, it's kind of a wild and crazy game so far, but start out with what went wrong with Paige Parker in the circle tonight.
I just don't think she had her stuff. She just couldn't find the strike zone well enough early. So it happens. We've got enough on staff to handle it. So Mariah's in. Great experience for a freshman. That's what we want. Paige Parker's warming up. I got Nicole Mendez ready to come in. So we're throwing it all out there.
Where do you go from Lopez right now, though?
It depends on how far she goes. Nicole Mendez can come in from right field and help us get out. She throws the ball down, mixes speeds well. And Lowry's feeling great, so she's down in the bullpen.
In an ideal world, how soon would you bring Lowry in, even planning a little bit for tomorrow in case you had to go game three?
I don't know. We're looking maybe around the fifth or so. Not sure. So we'll see. We'll see how Mariah's doing. And they feel good, so we'll just see how it plays out.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Holly. Well, if they had to think about it, Nicole Mendez has only pitched a third of an inning in this postseason. She has not appeared in the World Series, but for right now, it is still Lopez. And she will face the top of the order, Amanda Lorenz. First team All-American. Tops on the Gator roster in batting average, home runs, slugging. Batting .412 in this World Series. The sophomore following up her season a year ago, the best freshman season in school history. And has set about rewriting the record books in Gainesville, where that's not an easy thing to do. They have had some awfully good hitters over the years. Talk about the likes of Lauren Hager and Kelsey Stewart and Kirstie Merritt, Aubrey Monroe, just to name a few from their
Francesca Anaya
back-to-back title teams. And then if you go back further, Anaya and that whole crew.
Kelsey Bruder, all of them. Big boppers. And that was back in the day when Florida was more of a home run hitting team. They they would just bash the ball out of the park.
Megan Bush was the SEC's leader for a while. Going opposite, down the line, and foul. Hatfield gets the jersey dirty.
When you think about those Florida teams that had so many home runs, opportunities to win a national championship in the championship series, but unable to get it done. I think Coach Walton then having a different style athlete come in, speed, a little bit quicker, hits for average. Like we like to say, speed doesn't slump. You know, sometimes the home run hitters can get shut down by power pitchers.
To Lorenz, back to the track, and it will stay in the park. Penley's got it.
Amanda Lorenz continues to impress, and this is a just missed ball. It's a changeup. She gets it off of the end of the bat. So this is her miss hit, folks. She gets it off the end of the bat. You see she's a little bit beat because it's off speed, and look at where she hits it, 219 feet, just barely missing from clearing for a home run. You look at the future of the game and a lot of the athletes that we're going to see in the next Olympics and the national team and the pro league.
DeWitt swings at the first pitch. Hatfield spinning around to make the grab. Two down.
Amanda Lorenz is going to be a part of that. And there's a lot of players that have been in here in this tournament. And you think about it, they're 19, 20, 21 years old. They haven't even gotten to where they're going to reach their peak, and that's what makes this so exciting.
And they're going to continue to develop, and they're going to need to, because Jess, as you know, in the Olympics, the field is 220 feet all the way around.
Bigger.
So bigger, 20 feet bigger down the lines, which is significant because the ball is very different. It doesn't fly as well. The bats aren't as lively.
And probably will be an entirely new experience for everybody that makes the team. The last Olympics was 2008. Be 12 years removed in Tokyo.
Mariah Lopez can get that pitch called all night tonight. I would live there. That's off the plate. It's not a strike, but close enough to where it can get called one, and she needs to miss these Gator bats just a little bit more. The last two outs have been hit hard.
And the freshman gets through the top of the order. 1-2-3. The drop ball for the strikeout and a one-run OU lead. Holly Rowe with the Gators mentor, Tim Walton, on the other side.
And here with the Gators head coach Tim Walton. And coach, kind of a crazy game back and forth right now. What is your plan moving forward? It's a do or die for you guys, elimination night. So how long do you stay with Gourley, and do you even think about trying to save Barnhill?
We don't think about saving anybody. So we're ready with Barnhill. We'll go back to Ocasio again. That's really our plan, just trying to get Delaney as many innings as we can to give our offense a chance. We gotta find a way to score a run pretty quickly before they bring the big left-hander back in.
You've already chased Paige Parker. They're down to their third pitcher right now. So what are you saying to your hitters? They seem to be getting some really great contact.
Yeah, we've been making good contact two days in a row. I just told them not to pay attention to the scoreboard. You just don't worry about the scoreboard. Win your individual at bat. Go up there and do your job and give us a chance to win a ball game.
Thanks, Coach. Okay,
thank you.
Thank you, Holly. And Coach Walton. Gators, their fifth time here in the championship series. They are 2-2. Trying to become the sixth one seed in 13 years to win a championship. They've got two. Alabama has won three SEC titles for the conference that has really started to take charge. They got 12 of their 13 teams, or excuse me, all 13 teams into the tournament this year. It was a strong season for the Pac-12. They had three teams here at the World Series. And then Oklahoma and Baylor were both here. But it really has been these two, Michelle, that have been kind of slugging it out. One or the other has been in the finals in each of the last six seasons. They've each won it twice. Reynoso scooped out of the dirt by Kvistad, one down.
I think the way the year started for Oklahoma, you weren't sure if they were going to get back to this point. They had stubbed their toe a little bit early. There were some doubts. But cleaned it up late season, and actually I think have North Dakota State University to thank that first loss of the postseason. They were schooled, as Patty Gasso said, and they've been, the ship's been righted since that loss.
Top of the order in Mendez. Solo home run in the first inning. Grabbed the lead. Then Florida answered with three in the second. And then Oklahoma struck right back with four in the bottom of the second. Gators picked up another in the third. Two down.
And then both these clubs come into Oklahoma City, and their paths to this championship series very similar. They're 3-0, great pitching, really good offense. And that's what made last night's game just so exciting and epic, is that it was like the momentum and everything was building, and it just exploded.
For 17 innings.
17 whole innings.
But you could just see how well matched they were. Yeah. And the depth of the staff, which I think is what really allowed that game to go deep.
Yeah.
Gourley facing Clifton. If Oklahoma wins, they are the champs for the second year in a row. If Florida wins, it's game three tomorrow. Same bat time, same bat channel. One to Clifton, and a base hit opposite. So that could be big for Clifton, because now you bring Shea Knighton up with a runner on base. Three-run double. Cleared the bases in the second. Three-run home run. Won it last night.
She took a pitch. It was a backdoor curve that leaked right back over the plate. The thing with Shade Knighton is she's so strong of a hitter. Not just the big hits, but you'll see her be able to bloop hits in. Her miss hits will turn into hits because of her strength.
And her eyes. I love watching her eyes. She is so dialed in on the pitcher's release point. The concentration, you can just see it.
When the ball left the bat last night, boy, did those eyes light up. She knew it instantly.
She went right into her home run shot. Like, as soon as she hit it, she just threw her arm up in the air.
230 feet it went.
And she struck out on that same pitch in the fourth inning off of Barnhill. She was ready. If that pitch was going to be thrown to her again, she was going to square it up, and boy, did she.
Gourley wins the showdown with Knighton. Strikes her out, side retired. A one-run game through four.
Delaney Gourley working the off-speed backward rotation. Gets Shea Knighton to swing through it.
Welcome back to Game 2 of the Women's College World Series. USA Softball Hall of Fame Stadium in Oklahoma City. The Sooners with a one-run lead as we move to the top of the fifth. And another pitching change. Nicole Mendez, just 12 games, only 17 and two-thirds innings of work all season. Most of those early in the year. And she will come on to face 4, 5, and 6 in the order.
Mendez is all drop and changeup. She just works the lower part of the zone. So I'm sure Coach Gasso and company are thinking, you know what, let's let the defense work, pitch to contact, keep the ball, if possible, in the yard.
She's coming in from right field. and we showed her warming up. So she was playing right field. Folly of you now, the DP goes to right. So in this game, oh, by the way, she had a home run in the first inning. So this is an everyday player that does not get a lot of pitching time, finding a way to warm up to get into this game.
Just a third of an inning in the postseason. And the thinking here for Oklahoma, if they can get to the sixth inning with the lead, they can possibly go to Paige Lowry, their closer. Florida has Kvistad, Wheaton, and Reynoso to try and change that. A walk and a hit by pitch for Kvistad after she went 0 for 7 last night.
And tonight is a night where you can be choosy in the box. Pitches close to the zone are not being called strikes.
Romero, one away.
And so you want to get into a leveraged count like that, but you need to hit that ball a little more square.
They came back twice to tie the game last night in both the 7th and the 12th innings. Threatened again in the bottom of the 17th.
Well, and if you're the Gators right now, you know this is probably a one-inning deal. Unless she goes 1-2-3, maybe she comes back in the 6th. But you want to be able to take advantage knowing that awaits the big velocity Paige Lowry.
About that change at 47, much slower than they were just looking at from Lopez.
I see you, Mendez, coming from right field, get in on the hands of some of these batters, throw, mix in a little changeup. She's making this look a little bit easier than it really is.
Slow roll to Romero. Two down.
And Mendez, with all of her tools, she took pitching lessons from Amanda Scarborough when she was young growing up. Scarborough with a great changeup herself, the ability to locate pitches. And, you know, and even though she's not an everyday pitcher, when you can locate low and mix speeds, you're going to be hard to hit, especially if you work ahead and you don't issue free passes.
Here's the home run hitter back in the second inning, Sophia Reynoso.
Reynoso taking a pitch up in the zone off of Paige Parker. That rise ball just does not get up, and she crushes it.
Redshirted last year, was injured, jumped right into the starting lineup at shortstop this season, a member of the all-freshman team in the Southeastern Conference. Had the big RBI double to tie the game in the bottom of the 7th. Forced extra innings last night. It can be done. In the 12 years of the tournament, three teams have lost game one of the Champ Series and come back to win it. Most recently, Alabama over Oklahoma, by the way, in 2012, when the Crimson Tide were dancing in the rain with Jackie Traina and Kayla Broat. Barnhill went back out to the bullpen and now is back in to the dugout. Check swing foul, Reynoso.
Yeah.
If Mendez can get Sophia here, six outs away from a championship. Arnold. What an inning for Mendez on in relief. The third pitcher gets him 1-2-3, and it's still a one-run lead.
Visit commonsense.org.
This party started early on. First inning, Nicole Mendez gets on the board with a solo shot to lead off the game, and this was a sign of things to come because in the second, Sophia Reynoso responds with a home run of her own to tie it up for the Gators. They would go on and score two more runs that inning. And of course, Shane Naughton, the bottom half of the second inning. She's not going to be quiet. All the things that she's done here in Oklahoma City, a three-run double for Oklahoma to take the lead. And Chelsea Herndon goes yard to make this game within one. And that's where we stand now. Oklahoma 5-4. A ton of offense and 12 hits between these two teams.
The if necessary game three of our championship series between Oklahoma and Florida would be tomorrow night at 8 Eastern on ESPN. Fale of you to lead things off 4, 5, and 6 against Delaney Gourley. We only go to that third game if the Gators come back and win it tonight. After OU won the classic 17-inning game one that lasted for 5.5 hours and nearly 500 pitches. As a result of that, we've had a hodgepodge of pitchers, five of them. A couple of Gators, three Sooners in the circle tonight. Saw Paige Parker briefly. She was chased in the second inning. Have not seen Kelly Barnhill yet. Have not seen Paige Lowry yet. Full count. The senior from Lakeside, California, trying to get her team to Wednesday night. Kvistad down on her knees to make the play. One away. Let's take a look at the Capital One Cup standings. As teams compete for a combined $400,000 scholarship donation from Capital One, the winning team of the World Series will receive 60 points towards the Capital One Cup. Ohio State atop the men's and leading the women's.
I see something very much in common. Stanford's on both of those lists. Oh. Leading the women's, number three on the men's.
North Carolina.
Nerd Nation power.
Yeah, was on there as well, Nerd Nation.
Fear the tree.
Stanford grad Jessica Mendoza.
That's right.
Go Pokes grad Michelle Smith.
That's right.
I'm Beth Mullins along with Hall of Fame Stadium reporter Holly Rowe with you here for game two. And our entire crew on the job for 12 hours yesterday and manning their posts for 5.5 to bring you that epic showdown last night. Reno to Pendley.
And as hard as the runs were to come by last night and as plentiful as the strikeouts were, it's the complete opposite. We've got runs going up all over the board. Just 4 strikeouts in tonight's game. 40 last night through those 17 innings. Crazy.
And still a close game. And I think that's the beauty of what these two teams are bringing. As Nicole Pendley laces a single into left field. But, I mean, even though the pitchers aren't dominant like they were yesterday, I mean, there was a no-hitter going into the fifth for the Gators last night until the bats started to come around. But this game is not done because these two teams are so evenly matched. It's hard to predict.
I think the thing that was amazing for me, too, the 17 innings, one club threw 249 pitches, the other 247, just
wow.
A two-pitch difference, hits, all of that. There were so many similarities.
Let's make it a best of seven. Let's just do it.
Love it. Love it.
Well, we basically played two last night. Here's the third one tonight so far. Penley on board, Romero at the plate. They have developed into quite an impressive trio when you talk about Penley and Romero and Knighton and the success that they have had in the postseason, trying for their second straight national title. Kvistad's got it, steps on the bag at first. Side retired. Gators still have time.
Haley Kvistad, a nice job with the line drive reacts, being able to get the double plays. This ball just leads her right to first base.
Over the last four seasons, it has been all Sooners and Gators, including Florida going back-to-back in 2014 and 2015. Oklahoma, with eight underclassmen in the lineup, winning the national championship last year, trying to go back-to-back. There was one of the seniors on last year's club, Aaron Miller, winning championships in 2016, and the other ring from 2013. Beth Mowens, Jessica Mendoza, Michelle Smith, kind of been building towards this all year. We talked a lot about the parity during the regular season, but the way they played in the World Series, no surprise that these two are back again.
Well, I mean, even coming in, you couldn't pick one team, say this team's going to win it all. But when we got to this point, these teams just so evenly matched, and we haven't seen any errors. We haven't seen misplays. I mean, these are two of the best in showcasing the best of softball.
Yeah, just a fun game all the way around. Great pitching staff, some really good timely hitting. Maybe not as much last night as there's been tonight. But just the ability to highlight our game at the highest level. That's what I love, especially now that we're coming back into the 2020 Olympics. It's just an exciting time for our sport.
7-8-9 due up. Mendez will stay in and pitch, but it's a pinch hitter here, Jordan Roberts. Mariah Lopez set down the top of the order in the fourth. Mendez 1-2-3 in the fifth. And the Sooners are going to stick with her here. Even though after Roberts, Herndon has a home run and McQueen has a single. So the bottom of the order has hit for Florida. Have not seen Mendez. Check in with Holly.
Just think of how incredible this is. Mendez is a freshman. In a College World Series game championship clinching possibility, she comes in from right field to pitch. Does not surprise any of her teammates at all. They have told us she is the best player on our team. She is a stud. Even all of these players that won a national championship last year look up to her as a freshman. I just find it remarkable that they're leaning on her, a right fielder, a freshman in the circle in this moment in a championship effort.
The Big Ten Freshman of the Year. Didn't even move into the starting lineup till mid-March.
And one of the things I noticed, too, with Nicole Mendez is she does a really nice job of hiding the ball for a long time. In a day of pick pitching, which happens so often, and we've seen it in this game, we've seen it throughout the postseason, if you watch when she gets the ball and holds it in that glove, that allows it so difficult for the side because it's the dugout. And right now, as a lefty, it's that Florida dugout that's right there, able to see pitches, be able to see grips. And as a freshman, does a really good job of that.
And I misspoke, not Big Ten, of course, Big 12 Freshman of the Year. Houston, Texas. But it's Jordan Roberts right now trying to start a rally for Florida. And that might do it. Pinch hit, base hit to left. And now it's the home run hitter, Herndon.
Chelsea Herndon back in the third inning. She got so much of this one, only her fifth of the season, but a big one. We're seeing so many hitters right now being able to take advantage, whether it's pitches left over the middle, the fact that they've seen so much, and honestly, a little bit of adrenaline when you get into championship atmosphere.
239 feet on that home run. That was the last hit for Florida, and this may be the pitching change now for the Sooners to bring in their closer, Paige Lowry, who we saw yesterday hitting in the mid-70s. Mendez will return to right field. Lowry coming on, tying run on base for the Gators. World Series presented by Capital One. The night setting here in Oklahoma City. Beautiful evening for game two of our championship series. And getting into the late innings. And Paige Lowry will come on, the starter yesterday, returned to finish the game, and now back to her usual role as the closer.
And I think what's amazing is you look at those 139 pitches, but that was over 10 innings. That means she averaged about 14 pitches an inning. That's extremely efficient. That's where you want to be. 3 to 4 pitches per batter. But on to try to close the biggest game of her life.
Herndon with a runner on and nobody out. So she's the go-ahead now at the plate.
Remember, because Roberts was able to get on base, now this allows the top of the order to possibly get in a bat, which is Amanda Lorenz, who would be up third.
Herndon trying to lay down the bunt. Trying to bounce back from the loss last night. The Gators' 4 postseason losses. They have come right back to win their next game on the previous 3 occasions. And they have to do it here or the season's over.
Walton letting her swing away. He wanted her to get that sacrifice down. She missed the first strike. Lets her swing. The second strike, obviously she'll be swinging away now, but her biggest goal, moving this runner to second base.
Herndon the grounder to Clifton, who will make the play over to first. So it's just as good as a sacrifice, one away. The scouting report on Paige Lowry.
Lowry is all about that velocity, her ability to locate pitches, and that's what it is. She'll jam you inside. She likes to confront righties inside. You'll be late. They shift at times when right-handed hitters are up because she sprays the ball right side, but it's that outside pitch that she throws to lefties. It's hard to barrel up, and inside to lefties as well with great velocity up to 68 to 72 miles an hour.
As you see 73 pop up there, that's equivalent to almost over 100 miles an hour in baseball because of the distance and the reaction time. So she's really liking Aroldis Chapman coming out of the pen.
Justine McLean's been a tough out, 4 for 7 through the first 2 games of this champ series. And the adjustment for the Florida hitters, we're talking about 13 to 15 miles an hour that the eyes and the hands have to catch up with. O2 to McLean.
See how shallow the outfield is. Justine McLean, known for her short game, so she's trying to just bloop something in there.
The road to Omaha continues this weekend with baseball super regionals beginning Friday at noon on ESPN2. For more information on the College World Series, go to NCAA.com, the official online home for all 90 NCAA championships. The winningest program in the country the last 10 years. They've lost a couple finals. They've won a couple finals. And have moved to the top of the SEC in each of the last 3 years. McLean and the infield, or the outfield, which was playing in, well positioned. Two down.
And up to bat is Amanda Lorenz, the best hitter for this Gators offense. What did she do last night? Her team was down two runs to the Sooners in the bottom of the 12th. She put two more back on the board with the biggest hit of her life. And Amanda Lorenz has been on fire this postseason with first base open. Leah Wodak calls timeout. Do you throw to her?
Do you?
No.
No. Because that hit, by the way, was off of Lowry last night.
And I think they're going to try to maybe make her chase. I would just put her on.
Because one swing could give the Gators the lead. You go right at her.
And even her outs throughout this championship series have been, I mean, her last hit, she missed clearing the wall by a foot. And that was a miss hit.
Yeah. Well, I think if you do challenge her, you stay on that inside corner and see if she can catch up to the velocity.
DeWitt, who's right behind her, does have a hit tonight. But you're looking at the possibility of letting their best player tie this game up or take the lead here.
Now they did walk Lorenz back in the second.
Yep.
And it did hurt him that DeWitt and Ocasio both singled to be able to get another run in.
Two and two.
And that's where she's looking. And,
yeah.
you can just tell. And that was what she hit against Lowry last night. It's the pitch away because velocity, you want to just let it travel and literally just get to the ball.
Which is why I was like, throw her inside, confront her inside, make her have to barrel it up and turn on it. It's much harder to do.
And she struck her out. Lowry stays low in the zone and gets the strikeout of Lorenz to end the threat. 5-4 OU to the bottom of the sixth.
The NCAA Women's College World Series is presented by the Quicksilver Card from Capital One. Earn unlimited 1.5% cash back every purchase everywhere. And in part by Verizon. Not just unlimited, Verizon Unlimited.
The defending national champions, the Oklahoma Sooners. And a three-game championship series last year against the Auburn Tigers, taking game one, losing a stunner in game two, and then Paige Parker coming back to win game three for Oklahoma's third national championship. And now they are looking to go back-to-back, just three outs away from doing that, but a very tenuous one-run lead. They are the lowest seed to get into the championship at a number 10 seed and would be the lowest seeded champ in history. in 36 years. They'll have another swing here and then send Paige Lowry back out to try and end it. Florida must come back and win tonight to force game three. Twice last night, the Gators were down to their final strike and rallied to tie the game before succumbing in the 17th inning. Bottom of the order here to face Gourley. Hatfield, Wodak, and Arnold, the rally starters back in the four-run second inning. They all reached, they all scored.
And they all reached against Alicia Ocasio. Makes you wonder if they made that change a little bit earlier, came to Gourley. Maybe when the bases weren't loaded or in a different situation, how that would have affected the game.
Or started Gourley. Yes. And that's what I thought they would do
too.
Just because she was dominant, really, until she got so fatigued and they came back with Barnhill. But Gourley in that changeup.
A strikeout for Delaney, one down. Get inspired this week on ESPNW, all the social media, and the reaction from the thriller last night in game one. Also, the breakdown of the numbers for a game that lasted 5.5 hours. And Graham Hayes' article on fatigue impacting the players. We played three last year. We played three the year before. Six of the last seven games in the Champ Series have been decided by a single run or gone into extra innings. Leah Wodak, 1-2. Top of the seventh inning, the Gators will be sending their 2, 3, and 4 hitters to the plate. So the opportunity will be there. Another strikeout for Gourley, two down. Captain Kelsey Arnold. Building relationships this year for the Sooners in the dugout for Patty Gasso, who's got her son on the coaching staff, daughter-in-law, as a volunteer assistant. Former player and longtime assistant, Missy Lombardi, who's been right there every step of the way.
And I love the way she calls Missy Lombardi the head coach of the pitchers and catchers. She completely trusts her. Even though they talk a lot of times about it, it's a team decision. It's a community feel with on the team to take ownership. Lombardi has just been fabulous working with that pitching staff.
Seeing holding up the number three, the power of three. You see a lot of the players with the heart. KN, the daughter of a former player who passed away this spring. Always on their minds, always right there on their hats and helmets. Pulled to second, and it's bobbled by DeWitt.
DeWitt pulled way in because of the short game of Arnold. You can see the ball just kind of bounce up. And this is where speed, you have to rush. And you see DeWitt a little too fast. Gets the error.
Top fielding team in America. And that's just her third error of the season. Gets the top of the order up and a chance to pad the lead. Mendez hit the home run back in the first.
How about the versatility of Mendez? We've seen her in right. We've seen her pitch. We saw her go yard with the home run you mentioned, and now showing off a little short game with the slap. I don't know if she'll stay with it, but a lot of times she might start and at bat with it.
Runner goes. Arnold sliding into second, safe.
And I love that. I love that Arnold. I love Oklahoma reading pitches, knowing that they have an opportunity to steal when the changeup is thrown. Arnold going to take off on the pitch, reading it. Tough pitch to throw on for Janelle Whedon because it takes a while for that pitch to get to her before she can get it down to her shortstop.
Now they got the runner in scoring position.
Mendez was the first hitter Gourley faced tonight when she came in. She struck her out on a changeup. Pretty sure they're going to go back to that pitch with two strikes.
Went to the curve to strike her out. Side retired, and it's the last chance for Florida as we head to the top of the seventh. The Sooners, three outs away from going back to back. Florida's been here before, in fact, a couple of times last night, down to their last strike, and they rallied.
Two outs, two strikes. Reynoso was the one that got it done to score. Ocasio to tie it up. And then in the 12th inning, after OU went ahead by two runs, Amanda Lorenz again down to two outs, two strikes. She puts two on the board with a double to tie it up. So this is familiar territory for the Gators, just last night doing it twice.
Have they got another one in them? DeWitt, Ocasio, and Kvistad to face Paige Lowry.
Look at that crowd. All of them on their feet right now for this last inning.
Sooners get three outs. They win their fourth national championship and their third in 5 years, and the dynasty is theirs. Florida won back-to-back in 14 and 15. They would like to play for a third title in 4 years tomorrow night. Change, 0-2.
Paige Lowry, after blowing the ball at 74 miles an hour through the zone, comes back with a changeup. Doesn't have to be perfect. Her mentality, her use of visualization, seeing
strikeouts, seeing swing throughs.
And just perspective, that was 59 miles an hour, the pitch prior. She bumps it up to 75. That's the importance of utilizing that pitch, a pitch she rarely threw last night.
Held up. Terry Holt, Scott Thomas, and Aaron Peterson. The umps tonight. Wodak tried to pull that back into the zone, 2-2.
Staying explosive, shows it a little bit at the
good
end.
Call. It's a good call, it's a ball.
60 mile an hour changeup.
Struck her out. Two outs from a title.
And the setup pitch is a changeup so that you can come hard on the outside corner at 70 miles, 75 miles an hour. Look at the way she's going to get over the top of this ball. Look at the ump cam. It is just blowing heat on that outside corner. Lowry from the left side. Peyton, that corner.
Alicia Ocasio. She had one of those two-out base hits yesterday. Swinging at the first pitch, and it will trickle foul.
And that ump cam on the strikeout gives you an idea of just how little reaction time these hitters have. So you have to make a decision. We're talking split second whether you're going to swing or not. And that's what's going through for Alicia Ocasio right now.
They opened up the NCAA tournament with a loss, stunned at home. Regrouped, rediscovered the passion to play and the hunger to win, and have won 10 games in a row since. They lost a couple of key players, but they added Paige Lowry in the circle. And it has made a world of difference.
In the battle of the Gators, Tim Walton said, win our at-bats, win an AB. Fouling off pitches.
With another change, one out away.
So this time in reverse order, uses the hard stuff to set up the slow stuff. And it doesn't always have to be perfect. Down in the zone, but it's the change of speed. Ocasio, well out in front.
The game ended in the 17th inning last night, with Paige Lowry striking out Kaylee Kvistad. They meet again.
Facing velocity, 74, 75. If you have the strength of Kaylee Kvistad, and can just get your barrel to the ball, you don't have to swing hard. That's when the big hits happen.
Back to Lowry, over to first. Oklahoma goes back to back to win its fourth national championship. A third title in 5 years as they beat Tennessee, Auburn, and Florida.
This series will go down in the history books. Not just the 17 innings they played last night, but the fact that both of these teams so well matched, as you see the emotion of Patty Gasso breaking down, because the last 2 days have been the best softball from both of these teams, and you couldn't predict who was going to win. It was historic.
Yeah, both of these clubs, both of these programs honored our game, showed what is so great about our game. And you can't say enough about Florida, the season they had. Delaney Gourley, a senior, who will now take off the Gator jersey and slip on Team USA's jersey. Still has a wonderful, wonderful career ahead of her. But the Gators, just so much fight throughout the year.
A second straight championship, another Norman conquest for the Sooners, who, oh, by the way, only have one senior in the lineup tonight, as Lowry goes to Knighton for the final out and the celebration begins.
And just the fourth team in history to go back to back, share that distinction with UCLA, Arizona, Florida, and now Oklahoma.
The trophy goes up and will head to Norman for the third time in 5 years.
They lost to Tulsa the first game of the postseason. North Dakota State. Back the first game that they played, they faced elimination and fought their way back to a national championship.
Shay Knighton, the sophomore from Buena Park, California, had the game winner last night, a three-run home run in the 17th inning. The game winner tonight with a three-run double, and she is with Holly.
Well, Shay Knighton, this group struggled early in this season. You were down to a final out early in the regional round, and now here you are as repeat national champions. What was the hardest part to getting to this moment?
Just figuring it out. We were beating our own selves at that point, and at that point when we were down to our final out against Tulsa in our regional, we were like, you know what, just go for it. We're not trying to lose at our own regional, in our own house, no. And we put our heads together and said, we're going to finish this thing. We're going to do it the right way.
What is the right way?
Sooner way. Sooner magic, what you just saw, that's it.
You adopted after that loss this motto, the power of three, a three-run home run last night, a three-run double tonight. Why is your team believing in that motto right now?
I think because it's helped us get through those times where we needed it the most. We believe in God and what he's given us, the God-given talents, and we couldn't have thanked him anymore, and it's because of him that we're here. He's put us through all those trials just to get us to realize what we actually had to do.
tonight your pitchers were tired. Paige Parker struggled. She's normally so steady. How did the batters and how did the rest of the team have the backs of your pitching staff in this moment?
We just knew that everyone was tired. Like, the other team was tired, too. We just had to fight for what we wanted. And to see Paige struggle, we knew that that's when we had to turn it on. And we have Paige's back. She has our back. Even though she wasn't pitching, she was the loudest cheerleader in our dugout. And it was really cool to see because she never wanted to be out. But she knew what she had to do, and she knew it was a team effort to get this done.
I see your coach, Patty Gasso, overcome with emotion. I've never seen her cry like this on the sideline. What is it that that woman brings to this team?
Energy, love, just straight up passion. We see her and her grit and her determination to get things done, and we just want to feed off of that. We want to do it for her, do it for our crowd, do it for our families, and do it for our university. So it's really cool to do.
And Shay, for you, you've come up so big on the biggest of all stages. In 11 Women's College World Series games, you have 16 RBI. Why are you at your best on this stage?
I don't know. I think it's just doing it for my team. We want one common goal, and that's all to win a championship. And for me, I love these moments. Like I said, these moments are my favorite, and I just want to excel for my teammates, not just for me.
National champion Shay Knighton, thank you.
Thank you.
And also the Capital One Tournament Most Outstanding Player, Shay Knighton, as the Oklahoma Sooners come from behind for the third game in a row to win back-to-back titles.
Well, think of the pitchers that they had to use to do it, even in tonight's game, because of what they had to follow last night. Nicole Mendez, Mariah Lopez, Paige Parker, and then to close it out, Paige Lowry. The pitch calling, everything that they had to do to barely beat the Florida Gators by one run.
And a resilient offense. After being shut down, struck out 26 times last night, were able to put some big numbers up on the board. The Sooners just so resilient.
A four-run second inning, and it holds 5-4. Oklahoma a winner over Florida. Coming up next to SportsCenter, be sure to join us on ESPN3 and the ESPN app for the postgame ceremony and trophy presentation. We will be back with more from Oklahoma City in just a bit. And thank you to all the softball fans out there who have been with us all year long, to all the new softball fans we've picked up along the way. 5-4, Oklahoma, the winner over Florida for a national championship. Here's SportsCenter.
World Series fans, on behalf of the NCAA, we would like to thank all the coaches and participants for an outstanding week of softball. We would also like to thank our host, the University of Oklahoma, Oklahoma City All Sports Association, and USA Softball Hall of Fame Stadium. And now, please turn your attention to the video board as we announce the 2017 Women's College World Series All-Tournament Team. From Oregon, Alexis Mack. Oregon, Mia Camuso. Washington, Ali Aguilar. Florida, Alicia Ocasio. Florida, Amanda Lorenz. Florida, Justine McLean. Florida, Kelly Barnhill. Florida, Delaney Gorley. Oklahoma, Paige Lowry. Oklahoma, Paige Parker. Oklahoma, Shay Knighton. Oklahoma, Nicole Mendez. Your most outstanding player of the 2017 Women's College World Series, Oklahoma, Shay Knighton. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the pitching circle, where members of the NCAA Division I Softball Committee will present the runner-up and the NCAA National Championship Trophies for the 2017 Women's College World Series. Players and coaches, please step forward and receive your award when your name is called. First, the National Runners-Up and Gainesville Super Regional Champions, the University of Florida Gators. Kelly Barnhill, Katie Cronister, Brooke Clemens, Nicole DeWitt, Chelsea Herndon, Jamie Hoover, Kaylee Kavistad, Amanda Lorenz, Lily Mann, Justine McLean, Alicia Acasio, Sophia Reynoso, Jordan Roberts, Teresa Swartfeger, Jackie Switzer, Alex Voss, Janelle Wheaton, Delaney Gourley, Manager Lauren Collier, Manager Sean Berger, Head Coach Tim Walton, Assistant Coach Jennifer Rocha, Assistant Coach Sharonda McDonald, Volunteer Coach Cody Dent, Student Coach Aubrey Monroe, Trainer Katie Davis, Strength Coach Wes Ohm, Manager Kyle Polanski, Video Coordinator Eric Logan, Assistant Athletic Trainer Aaron Hoeing, will the Gators team captains now come forward to receive the runner-up trophy? Once again, congratulations to the Florida Gators. And now, the 2017 NCAA Division I Softball National Champions, the University of Oklahoma Sooners. Players and coaches, please step forward and receive your award when your name is called. Kelsey Arnold, Fale Polima of you, Kaylee Clifton, Macy Hatfield, Shay Knighton, Mariah Lopez, Paige Lowry, Kylie Lundberg, Nicole Mendez, Melanie Olmos, Paige Parker, Nicole Pendley, Reagan Rogers. Sydney Romero. Hannah Sparks. Vanessa Takiaho. Leah Wodak. Head coach, Patty Gasso. Associate head coach, Melissa Lombardi. Assistant coach, JT Gasso. Volunteer assistant coach, Andrea Gasso. Director of Operations, Jackie Livingston. Athletic trainer, Christy Lee Miller. Strength coach, Zach Brulette. Equipment manager, Chase Brown. Graduate assistants, Brittany Williams. Lacey Waldrop. Jackie Bishop. Sports Information Director, Carl Anderson. Student Manager, Allison Fanning. Will the Sooners team captains now come forward to receive the NCAA National Championship Trophy. Congratulations to the Oklahoma Sooners. Advanced Championship merchandise is now available. Again, championship merchandise is now available at the Event One merchandise stands. Take home a piece of history. The NCAA would like to thank you, the University of Oklahoma, Oklahoma City All Sports Association, and USA Softball Hall of Fame Stadium for hosting this year's NCAA Women's College World Series. Fans, we thank you for your support of tonight's NCAA Division I Softball National Championship. We look forward to seeing you all back here next year as the 2018 NCAA Women's College World Series returns back to Oklahoma City, May the 31st through June the 6th. Ladies and gentlemen, have a good night, a safe trip home, and we'll see you back here next year. Good night.